You know, without a doubt, the UK is still institutionally racist.
In this country, in 15 or 20 years' time, the black man will have the whip hand over the white man.
Being black is a responsibility.
We must be mad. Literally mad as a nation.
There was a lot of brutality. So you've got this kind of tinderbox, and at some point that tinderbox explodes.
No white God.
Oh, the ends are fucked. Lift up. We're vexed because they're trying to forget about us.
We suffered, man. We suffered brutality, murders, all things. Just like those kind of atrocities that people don't remember.
The racism has been the one connecting factor.
That's what makes the UK one of the most dangerous countries on the planet. Music has always been part of the black struggle, and it always will be.
Now you ask a question and I'll answer now.
Tell me about when you first came to England. What brought communities together?
What brought communities together was the racism. Because we had to unite to be strong, because those days a black man couldn't go out on his own. Because you'll find a gang of teddy boys who'll trail him. We never expect nothing like that. We didn't expect nothing like that. Because remember, you know, when we were in Jamaica, we never seen no poor white man. But when we came to England now, we realized that there was poor white man, poorer than even we. We used to go into the betting shop like me, sir. Waldron, a peaceful guy, he was a mechanic, a law-abiding citizen. All he did was love off this white girl in the betting shop called Hazel. We warn him and tell him, say, Waldron, you see that white girl there? Leave her. Our people, them is racist. Them live at a place called Wittenshaw. No ear up, no, he wouldn't listen. So them have a pub up there. Him go there one night now. And the white boy, them wait till pub are closed. And then when the pub closed now, the whole of them dust him up, broke him up, mash him up. But them never know who Waldron was. You see where Waldron do? For 2 weeks, Waldron planning I made with revenge. Like you'd say, vengeance is mine, said the Lord. And Waldron get a machete and him sharpen both end. And Waldron planned. And Waldron went back up there with the machete in that long coat, and when the pub closed, Waldron just went wild. He damaged a whole heap of them. He was put away for 25 years. What I'm trying to show you, sir, how racism can create hatred. That's why I preach for peace and love between all nations. Whether you're white, black, or rascal, blue, yeah? We need to live good. So now, we through music, I unite this country, I know, in a sense where everybody, through reggae music, are coming together worldwide. The music and culture and our history is so strong. That is the power of Jamaica music.
I remember a musician said to me that if you want to know what was happening, listen to reggae music. We were able, as West Indians, to start to really solidify our stance. You know, we couldn't let a lot of people get away with the things that they were getting away with. September 9th, 1985, a friend of mine phoned up and he said to me, you better get back to Handsworth to get the pan fire. Riots. Put my camera in my pocket and packed as much film that I could and drove back. That's when everything just hit me. Smoke, people running, noise, choking, sirens. It was urban warfare. All here, this is where a lot of it was taking place, on the Lazos Road. Down here, I took that shot where we're all kind of crouching. It was a disturbance based upon a history of forced imprisonment, racism, no employment, you know, and there was a society who was left on the margins. You know, friends, you'd see them on Monday, and they say, what happened to you? And they got beaten up by the police. And, you know, you'd hear this again and again and again and again. And on that fateful day, everything escalated. This was part of the disturbances and the riots here. So as far as I can see, there were kind of buildings that were here, but all these buildings burnt down and demolished. They've never been rebuilt. Why, I really, really don't know, mate. There was, you know, people who I'd known for years and years and years doing things which I didn't think they would kind of do. You think, I know what's going to be in the newspapers the next day. You know, there's going to be angry-looking black youth with some kind of headline over there. So knowing what I knew, I just felt that I just had to kind of go off-center and document what I needed to kind of document. It's only later on you think, what? I could have got myself killed. Racism's never going to go away. It affects everybody. Because when you've got a community and that community gets burnt to the ground, it affects everybody. Not just young, old, black, white, everybody. There was a kind of them, them, and us.
What's the name, son? My name's Smiley Culture. Where do you think you're coming from? Like, from seeing my mother. What's the registration number of the card? And I can't remember. What you got in the building, son? I can't say it, Ricardo. Would you like to have a look? Like, bloody man, if we ask you answer. Now take the keys out of the car and step out of the motor. Me and my colleagues have got a few questions to ask ya. You'll be on your way as soon as we get an answer. As me come out to the camera, think of me, I wonder what police officer could want with Smiley Culture. With them touch, them I search the interior. But whatever them looking for, me hiding place superior. But the way them I search me, hard to ask them what them I look for. But me try handle them, cause them just handle me closer. Then one draw anchor, put him on palm me shoulder and say, where got no time, why sweet, I think you have neither. Just give us what we want, the real sense in mania. Me cut him shot and me just draw out me parka. And the producer, me just sign Smiley Culture. Them never lie, them never bother. Arrest me or take me ganja.
2011, you know, apparently the police raided his house and the next minute we're told that Smiley received a stab wound to the heart. It was a real shock, you know, it hurt me. And I know it hurt a lot of the black community. To see the families in tears and so hurt motivated me to help and do what I can. And it seemed like bodies were dropping all over the UK. And the more I researched the history of it, is the more shocking it became. That, you know, we have to remember there's never been one police officer in British history that has been convicted and sent to prison for a death in custody. As black people, we don't have that privilege of getting justice in this country. We have to fight and make a lot of noise to get the most basic justice. Music has always been part of the movement. It's always been part of the black struggle. From our ancestors, with just the simple beat of a drum, you know, is just the beginning to of what we have today.
Yeah. I've been on Pirate Radio, like, as an MC and trying to do that. And I always shot people the way that I would want to be seen myself, you know what I'm trying to say? I think sometimes, like, we get the stereotype of, like, being angry or having a chip on our shoulder and stuff like that. We're vexed because we've been put in a place where they're trying to forget about us and delete us from history. It's constant, like, it's every day. And if other people had to experience that, it wouldn't be like this, you know?
Tell me about David Cameron Hates the Man, then. Yeah, explain to me what you mean.
In what, David Cameron hates the man, then? He doesn't care about us. Like, he doesn't care about young black boys. My brother's passed away, and basically, my parents have met David. Under the circumstances, you'd think that he would do something, or because he's been, like, stabbed. And yeah, it was just weird that you could meet someone like that and there'd be no help. I'm just not accepting that this is the narrative for us. Like, this is the way that the world is for us. I don't think it's fair. You see this so much, you see it every day. You see the stabbings, or you see so much negative, like, no matter where you go, you know. What needs to happen is for us to do stuff and say stuff and it be based on our experience here. That the whole point of all this stuff is that preservation, man, and that documenting, and yeah, hopefully in 1,000 years, do you know what I mean? They can know that we was here and this is what we was on. But even for music or art, whatever it is, you can change the narrative, man.
All 28 gone bad boy.
The bass, it takes you to another level. The adrenaline jumps out your skin.
Whether I go to punk gigs, funk, soul, I'll just hit the dance floor. It's just a natural thing. We've come to dance.
It was like a rebel music. To me, that's what jungle was, you know what I mean? Proper energy.